Life here in Dubula Malale is frightening. It's dangerous because here we experience gunshots, war between the La Republic and the Ambazonian Defense Force. Here in Dubula Malale, we likely say we are not safe because at times we are being frightened by the gunshots. So when the Ambazonian Defense Forces do passes here, it creates a lot of tension. As you can see, the people you just met, they are displaced people. Most of my villagers, they have decided to pack out from the village because of seeing those Ambazonian Defense Forces passing and going to do, accomplish their mission.
The danger, is the danger coming from the Ambazonians, or it comes from government soldiers?
Yes, the danger is coming from government soldiers, because the Ambazonians, they are patriotic and they encourage us not to run away from them when we come across them. But the government soldiers, when they come, they just start shooting, killing innocent people. If you go to a corner, you will find dead bodies stinking and smelling down there in a corner. You go to Mamu, the same. So we are really afraid of the government forces, not the Ambazonian Defense Forces, because they are friendly to the population.
We have seen young kids outside there, and women, and a few men. If you could tell us what happened to these people.
Yeah, these people, they are displaced persons, and since they came here, no better infrastructure, no better housing for them, no good sleeping position for them, no good toilets for them. I mean, the people are in pains and they are sick right now. I registered the case yesterday, a child was sick. I struggled to administer some drugs our brother gave us to the child, and got up this morning, I saw that the child is getting better. So we are really suffering, and we need your help, particularly if foreign partners can come in, humanitarian people of good faith can come in and see how they can bring us. Even a health center will be better for us, for those little children. A better schooling infrastructure will be better for them too, and for those old people, because there are some old people who are getting almost blind, and others are weak. They cannot go to farm to get their daily bread, so we need help actually from the international community.
Any requests from the government?
As for now, the government should play its role as far as this crisis is concerned, because innocent people are dying while others are making themselves richer and richer every day.
Have you lost people in your village? If you can give us some figures.
Yes, as for now, we just discussed with the boss. We have gathered about 200 displaced persons from Mamu, Ekona, Munya, and even Bolifamba and Lisoka native. And as a matter of fact, all this is happening because their chiefs are not in on seat. Their chiefs too decided to escape, abandoning them in the village. That is why I decided to stay back home to see how I can handle the situation, as somebody who's having human feelings.
Chief, I see you live here. Are you not afraid for your life?
At first, I was afraid when I started living here. But as I started having population, I became used to the place. But now that there's war in our environment, we are all afraid of our lives.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome.